All right, we need to look at your homework here in section 6.2, and this was in your book on page 278. So look at problem number 35 here. This is in your book on page 278, and we're dealing with the inverse trig function. So number 35, we have the arc cosine. I think that pen's dead. We've got the arc cosine of the cosine at pi fourths. Now, there is a property where if you've got the arc cosine of cosine, it would just be that value here. But you have to be very careful about that, because sometimes these things may be outside, and I'll do one just a minute where you'll see, where something may be outside of the restriction for the inverse, because the inverse of cosine only goes from what? 0 to pi. So, for example, if this had been arc cosine, cosine 5 pi fourths, your answer is not 5 pi fourths. Does everybody understand? You've got to find that restriction between 0 and pi. This one's easy enough where we know that pi fourths is between 0 and pi, so this right here would just be pi fourths. Okay? And why is that? If I look, arc cosine of cosine pi fourths, if I let this be theta, well, no, what is this value? I have to let that be theta. What is that? Square root of 2 over 2. If I let that equal theta, then cosine of theta has to equal square root of 2 over 2, doesn't it? Between 0 and pi, where is cosine positive? Here in the first quadrant, where does cosine equal square root of 2 over 2? At pi 4. So does everybody see how it's just going to equal pi 4 here? Now, the difference I'm trying to get you to understand is go down and look at problem number 41. This is a good example of one where you need to think here. You've got the inverse cosine of cosine at 5 pi 4. What is your cosine at 5 pi fourths? Very good. Negative square root of 2 over 2, isn't it? So if I let this equal theta, then cosine theta equals negative square root of 2 over 2. So between 0 and pi, where does cosine equal a negative square root of 2 over 2? It's not at pi fourths. Where is it at? 3 pi 4, so what would theta have to be this time? This would end up equaling what here? 3 pi 4. So does everybody see the difference in those? Does everybody see the logic behind that? Right, any others there on 6.2? Let's do number 75 there. On page 279. We've got the cosine of the inverse sine of x over the square root of 12 plus x squared. So I'm going to let this here be theta. Not that. Gosh. I go home and go to bed. I'm going to let all of this right here be theta. Bye-bye, theta. Okey-doke. I'm going to let all that be theta. So then I'm looking for the cosine of theta. So over here I've got theta equals the inverse sine of this. So therefore the sine of theta has to equal this, right? Everybody agree? So if we draw our triangle here, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So what would this side here have to be? For some odd reason, I think it should be square root of 12. Now, how did I get square root of 12? I don't know, I could be wrong. Well, you would need to, it would be this, the square of this, square root of this squared, would have to equal x squared plus b squared, right? If I let that be b. So this would be 12 plus x squared equals x squared. What happens to your x squares? They cancel, so 12 equals b squared, so wouldn't the square root of 12 have to be that side right there? So what's your cosine? And you could write that all under one radical if you wanted to. Does everybody see this one? So is everybody okay here with section 6.2? Everybody all right here with section 6.2? Everybody okie doke?